You guys. All right, this next comedian, or comedian, I should say, she's a little person. She's only about this big. Oh my God, wait till you see her. I just want to pick her up and squeeze her. She's adorable. She might be little, but her funny bone is huge. I wrote that. All right, give it up. Tanyalee.
People. That's right. I know I'm different. It's okay. You can get over it. You know, I know. I'm biracial. Yeah, that means I'm a white girl. I'm a black girl. The booty's in the hizzle, people. Yeah. I love people's reactions to me. It's crazy. It doesn't matter where I go, especially kids, right? Because we all know kids are honest. No holds barred with the children, right? First thing off the top of their heads, they see me, they're like, hey, what happened to you? Did you get into an accident? I'm like, hell no. I didn't eat my vegetables when I was your age, you little shit. Now put me down. Luckily, I have a great husband that took care of me. Been married almost 7 years. It's awesome. People are like, are you really married? Is your husband a little person too? I'm like, hell no, he's 6 feet tall. Yeah, it's great because he's nuts over me. We have fun. No matter how long you've been married, or if you're not married with your partner, you gotta keep the spice alive, you know? My husband's a great guy, super affectionate, but I like to freak him out. That's my goal on a daily basis. Like this one time, we're on the bus. On the city bus, sitting there side by side. My husband wants to give me some hugs and some kisses and some lovin's. So he's leaning over to give me hugs and kisses. I'm like, Daddy, stop it! Some older lady's like, ooh! Like, don't worry, a kiss is better than Uncle Mark. Fun together. We go on adventures. That's what I call them, adventures. Yeah, like for instance, we attended our first Little People Convention. Yep, that's right, we have conventions. There's an organization called the LPA, Little People of America, and every year they have a convention in a different city around North America. 2 years ago, it happened to be in San Francisco. I'd never been to a convention, but let's give it a shot. Turns out it was the largest attendance they've ever had. 1,800 little people from all over the world invaded this hotel. And I had to arrive in the morning. My husband was coming on a later flight, so I showed up at the hotel by myself. I swear to God, I walked into the lobby and I just about shit myself. Yeah, I actually had a panic attack. I went up to my room, I called my husband. I'm like, you gotta get here, they're freaking everywhere! I mean, imagine walking into a room and seeing 1,800 people that look like you! Thank God they had free booze. Woo, yeah, picture 1,800 midgets drunk off our asses. Half of us got scooters, just driving around, running into shit. Woo, yeah, beep, 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 beep. Most of us were staying on the fourth floor of this hotel. Yeah, well, I figured out why, because nobody could reach the fifth floor button in the elevator. Oh, you know what? There was a Jehovah Witness convention going on at the same time. Yeah, you're familiar with the Jehovah's? Party animals. Of course, I was drunk one night, told my friends, let's stay up all night, right? So pissed out of my mind, 6 o'clock in the morning, start going around, bang, and on the Jehovah Witness's door, 6 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, I swear to God, all you could hear was, see anybody. Thanks a lot, I'm Tanyalee Davis.